In this lesson, we're going to look at the different types of radioactivity as well as how we show that in an equation showing that change. So this table shows the different types of particles which we will see being emitted, or the energy in the case of gamma rays. And so what we see is that there are various particles that can be emitted, and you're not going to have to predict what types of particles are going to be predicted. You're only going to know how to recognize these particles and how to complete reactions involving these particles. So here we notice that we have an alpha particle, looks like a helium atom, mass and charge. Penetrating ability is very low, and then the shielding required over here, which for alpha particles is simply clothing or a thick piece of paper, can stop alpha particles. As we move on down, what we see is that we see a beta particle, which basically looks like an electron, and either one of these symbols will represent that beta particle. No mass, a charge of minus one, so we see that here the mass number's on top, we see zero, and then the charge of minus one on the bottom. Low penetrating ability. Gamma rays, which is not actually a particle, so we see it has both a mass of zero and a charge of zero because we have no protons. And so this is just energy being emitted. And remember, radioactivity comes from, we have a particle that is not stable and it's trying to get rid of something to become more stable. Those are the three that are most commonly seen. We also see neutrons and positrons. And sometimes, instead of seeing neutron as a particle in a reaction, we will actually see the neutron as a reactant. So in the case of what we call neutron bombardment, we will see neutrons as the reactant. And again, there has to be additional information provided so that you know what particle we're looking at or where that particle will appear as a reactant or a product in that particular reaction. Now let's look at an example of a nuclear reaction. And so what we see here is we've got polonium as our reactant, which has the symbol PO. We have a mass number of 210 and an atomic number of 84. Now the atomic number we can get from the periodic table. Remember, 210 is a particular isotope of polonium that happens to be radioactive. On the product side, we see lead, which has the symbol PB, has an atomic number of 82, so that's our number of protons. And then we see helium as our other product, and remember that's also known as an alpha particle. And so what we see when we look at our nuclear reaction is that we have 210 equals 206 plus 4. So we see that the sum of the mass numbers on either side of the equations is equal. And in the atomic numbers, we see something similar. We see 84 equals 82 plus 2. Now, when we look at chemical reactions later, what we'll look at are the number of each type of element, because we don't change identities of elements from the left to the right because it's a chemical reaction. In a nuclear reaction, because we're changing identities, we can't simply balance out the number of each atom. Instead, we need to look at the atomic mass, which is the numbers on the top, and the atomic numbers, which are on the bottom. So now we need to look at another reaction where there's something missing. Notice here our one of our products is just listed as Z, and we have X and Y for the atomic mass and the atomic number. And we need to figure out what this substance is and what the numbers are for X and Y. So look at the values given for the atomic number on the left, the atomic number on the right, which is X and 4, and determine what the value of X is. So we have 226 equals X plus 4. So X will equal 222, because when I plug that in, I get equal a number on either side of the reaction. Now we can do a similar determination for the atomic number Y. So we look and we say we have 88 on the left equals Y plus 2 on the right. Therefore, Y equals 86. Now that we know the atomic number, we can actually identify the element. So if we look at the periodic table, we look for the atomic number 86 and determine the element. which is radon, or RN. Again, what we're worried about is that you find the symbol with the appropriate number, not that you know the name of it. And then when we look at this, we say, well, our atomic number is 86, and then our mass number will be 222. Now note, this number may not be what is the most common or the average mass that we see on the periodic table, but we are talking about very specific isotopes of an element. So this is radon 222 correctly completes this reaction.